In this example, we're going to practice graphing a parametric equation. The directions are graph the following parametric equations, indicate orientation with arrows on your curve. And the equations are x equals t and y equals t squared minus 1 for t values between 0 and 5. So when you're graphing a set of parametric equations, it can often be helpful to create a table of values. So let's do that in this case. So I'm interested in t values between 0 and 5. And what I'm going to do is I am just going to take those t values and plug them into these two parametric equations, and that will give me my x and y values respectively. So let's look at x first of all. I have the equation x equals t, so that's relatively simple. So for t 0 through 5, my x values are just going to be 0 through 5. And then my y equation is t squared minus 1. So if I plug in t equals 0 there, I should get negative 1. If I plug in 1, I should get 1 squared minus 1, which is 0. If I plug in 2, I get 2 squared minus 1. So that's 4 minus 1, which is 3. If I plug in 3, I get 9 minus 1, which is 8. Plugging in 4 gives me 16 minus 1, which is 15. Or plugging in 5 gives me 25 minus 1, which is 24. Okay, so what this has done is now I have a set of x, y points that I can graph. So let's go ahead and put those on our coordinate plane. Our first point here at time equals 0 is the point 0, negative 1. Okay, so somewhere approximately here. And then I have the point 1, 0. So x equals 1, y equals 0. And then the point 2, 3. So about here. And then 3, 8. 4, 15. And 5, 24. Okay. Now I've plotted 6 discrete points here, but this is a continuous curve, right? X equals t and y equals t squared minus 1. Those are both continuous, and I'm looking at the interval between 0 and 5. So then I want to go ahead and connect these dots to actually form my curve here. Now, I'm not going to extend this beyond this last point here because I'm cutting this off at t equals 5, and same on the other end, cutting this off at t equals 0. So this here then is the parametric curve defined by these equations over this interval of t values. Now the other thing that we're instructed to do is to indicate the orientation with arrows on our curve. So parametric curves have what's called orientation or direction. And then the direction in which a parametric curve is generated as the parameter t increases is considered the positive orientation or the positive direction. And we often indicate this with arrows on the curve. So what that means basically is I just think about where I'm starting with my t values. So I started here at this point 0, negative 1, and then as t increases, my curve goes in this direction, right, in the direction that I plotted the points. So I'm just going to add in some arrows to indicate that. Okay, and this is how we show the orientation of our parametric curve.